Mr. Yandunin, thank you for coming.
Thanks and let's for the invitation, yeah.
Start the conversation. He came to Magnit 9 months ago, and what was your first impression of this company?
Big. I was impressed with the pride of people. So there's a real Magnit spirit in Magnit. But I was also impressed with some of the systems that are actually not maintained. So there's a was also impressed with the size, in the sense of the geographical size, the how to control this, how to manage this. What most of all is the huge number of stores. So the opportunity to connect to customers on a daily basis is actually quite strong. Because the business is so big that there's a lot of impressions that you get. One of the things what was surprising for me is the fact that we do not only sell, we also produce. And the quality of production that we do is actually not in line with what actually was the image of Magnit, which I had. And what I also like is the fact that it's in Krasnodar. Krasnodar is an agricultural center of Russia. And I see that back in the business. We're very much focused on quality of products, on local, and I think we should maintain this. We should actually grow our competence in this area as well. Yeah.
And if we try to compare, for example, nine months ago and now, yeah. How it changed?
That's difficult to say, but I think what has changed is I think people understand better what we want to do. People also understand better what needs to be changed. I think people also know what the new management team actually has in mind. So what do we want to achieve? So the directions are clear. But like I said before, Magnit is a very, very big business. So it's like a tanker that you gradually but slowly start making to change the course. And I can give you a couple of examples where I see this. So the operational structure is in the process of changing, where we had a regional structure. We now go a bit more as well to a format structure. And we will see that as well in the commercial department. I think the customer orientation has changed. We've started doing more category management projects. I think the openness of the business towards suppliers has changed. If I look a year ago and now, we're more open to suppliers. We do more joint processes, joint projects. And I think also that's why you see how many suppliers have appeared today. I think suppliers also have waited for that change and see now, okay, wait, the culture is starting to become more like a modern retailer. Yeah.
More than 350 partners participate today in the conference. Yeah. And what is the key message you would like to give them and any new things that you can offer to them, to suppliers, to the partners?
I think the most important innovation or novelty for today is I want them to get the clear signal that where Magnit was a kind of closed, call it, hard negotiator. I don't want to be soft in the negotiations, but I know that in joint business planning, so talking to each other, having an interest for each other's problem and trying to solve that together leads in the end to a better result. And I want to invite them and to them to understand that, listen, that's the direction we want to go. Because if I make the processes better for you, you can also then give me a better price. If that understanding is not in there from supplier point, but also from our point, then we miss opportunities. And I think having only the tough negotiating style was a message, or was actually what we were known for. And I think the message should be that is going to change.
In your speech at the conference, you said that close and tough cooperation, yeah, that you mentioned now between Magnit and partners can help to achieve better results.
Yeah.
And in what way you can cooperate with the suppliers more tightly, and how you can help each other to improve your company in the market, to achieve more ambitions and to have a competitive edge?
I think what we will choose is, let me start with the last part, is the competitive edge. I think the competitive edge, what we see for us, is we're a producer ourselves. Mm-hmm. So we're able to have around 12-13% of the SKUs, so articles, on the shelf that we produce ourselves. I think that's a huge strength, which we have not been capitalizing on at all. What do I think with suppliers, where can we improve, is one of our weaknesses in the past and even now, which we have to improve, is our forecasting. Because what does a supplier want? A supplier wants to know, listen, how much do you need, when do you need, so that he can adjust his production and optimize his stock keeping. If we do not tell them when and how much, then how much stock do you need to keep? So it's never, either it's too little or it's too much. So you lose opportunities or it's too expensive. And I think talking to each other on demand forecasting, talking to each other on joint promos, talking to each other on what kind of impact do we believe this promo will have, leads to an optimized supply chain process. And one of the things that our category managers have never done is sit with the suppliers around the table and talk about working capital. So how much, because if I tell you, listen, keep 10,000 pieces for safety's sake, that's an investment. You need to produce it and you have to keep it in your warehouse. That does not come for free. So to have that understanding that, listen, that's also what we have to look at, is something that we need to get into the business.
Feedback, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And if I'm not mistaken, you mean that one of the weaknesses of the company is bad forecasting.
Yeah.
Yeah. And what other weaknesses you can notice?
Forecasting is a process of what do we have in stock, what do we sell, and what do we need to replenish.
Predict, yeah?
Yeah, mm-hmm. To predict. What is one of the things as well, what is weak, is there's the order of the store to the distribution center, which is also inaccurate. Because sometimes you run out of stock, and then the system does not anticipate this. So there's a lot of techniques that we have to improve to get that better. We're working on it, and I think also looking at the joint products that we have, there is already a big improvement ongoing. And that will lead to better forecasting as well. Yeah.
And you told me about the good side, the own production, yeah, of the magnet. And could you please comment how can it help to be more competitive in today's market? Yeah. Your own production, how to improve, how to win more a share of the market, and so on.
Now, I'm a strong believer that that in the current market, it's not all about price. Mm-hmm. So what is competitiveness? Competitiveness is also quality, transparency. I think we should play that card much better. So for instance, in our pasta factory, I can get you the cheapest pasta in the country. There is a market for that. But I can also get you the best pasta in the country. That comes at a price. So what we need to find out is, where does the Russian consumer stand? And what we've done is play the card of trying to get the cheapest. I think we should not be afraid to also go for a more value proposition. Okay, we can also get you a nice pasta for a very affordable price. Yeah? That's the pasta, but we have the same for what I'm still amazed with is the tomatoes. So we fight with our tomatoes with the market. So we try to offer it always at the price entry level. But our tomato is a bio tomato. So why would I not just tell consumers, listen, there is no pesticides here whatsoever in comparison to what you buy and you do not know. I can give you the guarantee. I can tell you how is this produced, where it's produced, what did we use, and yeah, how long it took to get on the shelf. Now, I can continue, it's the same with mushrooms and whatever.
Okay, you're like a head coach of a good sport team. Where you take the inspiration for a business? How you take the inspiration?
That's a very good question. That's also a question that I very often ask myself. how come the energy doesn't come down? I think one of the things is I love what I do. I am a retailer, so I get inspiration out of, okay, how does a store, I like to visit stores. I like to visit stores partly to shop, but also to see, okay, how does it look like? Is it logical? Do I understand what the category manager wants to do? And potentially I am a retail freak, but I think that's why I have that that ambition. I love it, and I love to work with people as well. So that's also important, because they give me energy. And lots of people from employee in the store till colleagues in the management team can be very inspirational for me. Yeah.
Modern manager in Magnet.
Yeah.
Who is it?
Okay. Now there was one thing on the slide. Which I decided not, because normally I use an anecdote for this. What I think is very important is that whomever you are, you're part of the team. And therefore, you win together, but you also lose together. Silos is what I don't want. I also am not interested in, I'm interested in causes, but I'm more interested in solutions. And a modern manager in Magnet should be aware that he is there for them, not they are there for him or her. That's a bit of a change, but I think it's vital. The second thing is, you're part of a team, so success is never your own, it's a result of all the players together. And if, like I've been a, because we decided not to mention this, but I've been a football player in myself. So if you see that one of your players has a difficulty, because then you try to compensate, to help. And sometimes you have to do more than another. But I think that's what you have to do as part of a team.
Today's Magnet team, is it a dream team or not? And how do you feel about Magnet, for example, in a few years, in 5 years?
I think if I look at the potential, I think we're a dream team. Where would I like to be in 4 or 5 years? I would like Magnet to be a modern, digital, customer-oriented, retailer that cares, that's conscious of it, the society it's in, where people have a clear view what we stand for, but also what we have as principles in the business. I think that's very important with regards to own production, with regards to private label, with regards to employer care and customer care. For me, if that's what we can achieve in 4 or 5 years' time, then I'm very, very happy. Yeah.
What can you say about the development of Russian food retail in a couple of years?
I think what you see is the landscape starts to crystallize out. So it's clear what are the players. What I think is, what you will see is, there will still be niche players entering the market, but I think the bigger players are defined. And I expect actually over the next couple of years, call it a consolidation. So bigger parties buying other parties in order to get to a normal, what you would say in all other more developed retail environments, retail landscape. So what you will see us do as well in growth, we will be looking at acquisitions, smaller ones, because in certain areas it doesn't make sense anymore to add stores. It's better than to buy stores.
And could you tell me, please, about the head office that are located in Krasnodar?
Yeah.
Maybe you think just relocated in Moscow or something where, I don't know. Yeah. It's common just for our country that everything that it is Moscow, and it's interesting that the head office of Magnitsky is located in Krasnodar. What do you think about that?
I think part of the charm of Magnitsky is that its origin is Kuban, is Krasnodar. We've got our own production here, we've got our greenhouses here, so I think it's unthinkable to disconnect Magnitsky from Krasnodar. And we should not even try. What is of course the case is that there are certain departments in Krasnodar which are difficult with regards to recruitment, with regards to competence, to fill up in Krasnodar. So we need to get our head around, okay, what are we going to do with those? Are we moving those to places like Moscow or St. Pete? And what does that mean for communication and connectivity? But I think the bigger issue that we have currently in Magnit is the whole discussion on structure. How do we manage this amount of stores from a format perspective and from a region perspective? And I think that's the first focus we should have before we start talking about moving to Moscow or having parts of the business go to Moscow. That would be very disturbing.
Couple of wishes for Magnit in a previous financial year?
I think we need time. I think we should focus on like for like. Underlying, I know that we're actually a profitable business, but we need to solve a couple of issues where we're working on. One of the things that I mentioned is the information system, so the ERP. We need to get a better ERP system in place which is capable of running a business size like this, because I think we're the only worldwide business of $20 billion of sales that runs on a platform like we do. You don't see that much, and certainly not in retail. So there we need to invest. Just from a financial perspective, what I hope is to see like-for-like improvements. I hope to stop the margin compression, so get more control on the amount of promos that we have to do. And I think that's not only my wish, I think that's the wish of all the retailers you will talk to. I also hope that we can stop the rotation of staff. We have seen, especially in the beginning of this year, a high rotation of staff, and we see that now coming down, which is, I think, is a sign of employer healthiness, and I think that's what we have to improve as well. Yeah.
Thank you for conversation.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.